Good evening. I want to welcome you to our annual Interfaith Thanksgiving service. A little bit different this year. We're virtual, of course, but awfully glad that you are here and glad that we can be together. I'm the Reverend Dr. Linda Anderson, affiliated with the Unitarian Universalist Fellowship in Stony Brook, and I am the convener of the Three Village Interfaith Clergy Association. Our theme this year is we need all of us. And we will reflect on that theme through music, through stories, through prayer. And we will reflect on it with gratitude that we are here, that we are together, that we each have something to contribute to our community, to our families, to our friends, to our workplaces, to all that we touch.
Good evening. My name is Kate Jones Colon. I'm the interim pastor at Setauket Presbyterian Church. And I want to also thank everyone for joining us this evening. This is such a special service each year when we come together as a community and give thanks for the ties that bind us across our various faith traditions. And so while we can't gather, we hope that you feel that connection tonight, and also leave filled with that gratitude for and commitment to building the beloved community with one another. To that end, immediately after the conclusion of this service, please stay on Zoom for a time of informal fellowship. We'll have an opportunity to greet one another and share Thanksgiving greetings with each other. If you're watching on our Facebook page, we'll be posting the link to this time of fellowship in the comments, so you're warmly invited to simply hop on Zoom when the service ends. And we encourage you to follow our Three Village Clergy Facebook page to be part of our interfaith community and all of the things that we do together. Finally, just a big thank you to all of our clergy, our community members, and our musicians who are taking part in tonight's service. So let us now prepare our hearts and minds for our service.
A story from Jewish tradition tells of a person wandering in a forest for several days, not knowing which way was the right way out. Suddenly, another person approached. The traveler's heart was filled with joy. "Now I shall certainly learn which is the right way." As they got closer, the first person asked the other, "My friend, tell me which is the way out. I have been wandering in this forest lost for several days."
The second person answered, "I do not know the way out either, for I too have been lost, wandering in this forest for many days. But I can tell you this. Do not go the way that I have gone, for it will lead you astray. Come, let us now look for the way out together." My friends, so it is with us. We have all taken separate paths. We are often lost. Thankful to have found one another, let us share our experiences and find the best way forward together. Loving and creating God, light and power of the universe, we ask that you bless this time as we give our praise and thanksgiving to you today for the wonder of your gift, for the beauty of the earth, for your grace and love so freely given.
In this uncertain season of COVID, we give you thanks for the gift of sharing in the responsibility of stewardship and care for this bountiful planet, in all of its natural beauty, wonders, imperfections, and challenges. For you have blessed us with the gift of relationship, the ability to learn, to work, to serve, and to care for one another with one another.
Help us now to dispel the hatred that we often see in our world, that we often find welling up inside of ourselves if we are not careful. Make us more loving, more peace-filled, compassionate people who are learning to care for your entire creation, in earth, in sky, in sea, and especially in your sacred creatures around us and in one another. As we enter into this time of worship and thanksgiving together, we pray that we all might come closer to you and your hope for the world.
We also pray that we would become closer to one another as we seek to work together when we are lost in times of darkness and uncertainty, that we might find a way together.
We pray that in this time of worship and wandering, we might share a new path, the true path that we jointly find, saying, "Come, let us now look for the way out together."
Gracious God, in doing so, create in us more grateful, loving, and clean hearts with which to live and serve in your world around us. May we sense your presence around us and within us in this time of worship and beyond. May we all be blessed to be a blessing upon your world. And all this we ask and pray in the name of our one Creator God, Mother, Father, Nurturer, Giver, and Sustainer of all. Amen.
I'm Sha'asanu, Sha'asanu, Betzalem Elohim. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu, Melech Haolam, Sha'asanu, Sha'asanu, Betzalem.
Good evening. Wishing you and your loved ones a blessed and peaceful Thanksgiving. My name is Sister Edith Menegas. I am Director of Pastoral Care and a board-certified chaplain at St. Charles Hospital in Port Jefferson and at St. Catherine of Siena Medical Center and Nursing and Rehab Care Center in Smithtown. I am a Roman Catholic sister, a member of the Ursuline Sisters of Tildonk, U.S. province. As I have reflected on our theme for this Thanksgiving service, we need all of us. I am reminded of my congregation's symbol that I am wearing right now, that we as vowed women religious, as sisters, receive at the liturgy when we offer our perpetual vows. Our motto on the back of this symbol is Ut Unum Sint, Latin for that all may be one, which Jesus says to us in the Gospel of St. John, chapter 17, verse 21, about his relationship with God, his Father. That all may be one, just as you, Father, are in me, and I in you, that they also may be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. My religious congregation is international, with over 1,000 of our sisters serving God's people in provinces in Belgium, our foundation, in India, Canada, the United States, the Congo, and with a mission in Guyana. We work together to make God known and loved in the world through our presence, our prayer, and our ministries, with a firm commitment to carrying out what Jesus has taught us and modeled for us to follow him, to welcome all, serve all, and be present to all, no barriers, no exclusions. That directive can also be found in John's Gospel, chapter 13, verse 34. A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another just as I have loved you, you also are to love one another. Again, I see our theme for this Thanksgiving service. We need all of us to love one another as I have loved you. Who is one another? Who am I called to love, to care for, to show compassion to aid, to assist, to empower? There is no list. The other is my neighbor, your neighbor, whoever is in need for whatever reason. And I do this, offer this with others. I do my part, you do yours. Imagine what our world could be, would be, if everyone did their part. We need all of us. Never has that been more evident than in this present moment, this year, 2020, with people around the world suffering in so many ways. We need all of us to work across racial, cultural, religious, and national boundaries to create a kingdom, not kingdom, but a kingdom where everyone is recognized and accepted as brothers and sisters, as beloved children of God. That takes effort, time, energy, focus, and commitment. That's not easy, and we are fallible human beings, many times in need of forgiveness, but we have been given a great responsibility to care for all of God's creation. For me, that is to push myself beyond and extend the love Jesus has shown to me to others. We need all of us, and we are called to care for those in need and for each other. I ministered with dedicated and caring staffs at both hospitals during the surge of the COVID-19 virus. We cared for patients, their families, and each other in so many ways, and we continue to do whatever is needed. We could not and cannot do this alone. We need each other, and we experienced and feel the support and care of countless people. We are all essential to the well-being of all. I am reminded of the ethical principle of reciprocity, the golden rule. Treat others as you want to be treated. Again, the term others, not some, not limited, but whoever is in need, whoever is before me. We all find ourselves in need. So many have shared to us here in the hospitals that it is the need for personal touch, a hug, a connection. Together, we can be that support in other ways, yet yearning for those things we have taken for granted. We need all of us. Together, we do make a difference. There is unity in diversity, as we each bring the gifts we have been given by God. I believe that when my time comes, when I transition from this life to the next, to eternal life, called home by God, I will be asked two questions. How did you love, and what did you do with the gifts I gave you? Hopefully, to the best of my ability, certainly not perfectly, relying on others when needed, always trusting in God. We need all of us. We did, we do, and we will. Thank you.
A human king stamps coins, and each one comes out looking the same. God, however, stamps the souls of human beings, and each one is different. Happy Thanksgiving. My name is Aaron Benson, and I serve as the rabbi of the North Shore Jewish Center. I share this passage with you from out of the rabbinic tradition, and it is one I think that speaks to our theme this evening, we need all of us. How does this apply? The rabbis were trying to say to us that the human soul, that the human being, unlike a coin stamped with the image of a king on it, where each coin, in theory, is meant to look the same, that the human being, although each of us stamped with the image of God in our existence, nevertheless, each one of us is unique, is created to serve some particular, some unique purpose that no other human being ever alive, ever to be alive, can accomplish other than each of us ourselves. And so this idea that each of us is unique is very important, but the comparison to being like money, to being like currency, I think also speaks to the value that human beings are supposed to have. Each of us is a unique and special creation of God. Each of us is equal to any other one, because we each bear that image of God in our souls and in our lives. However, each of us, if we think of ourselves like coins, like currency, is meant to circulate, is meant to convey and share value, is meant to make a community possible by building up the resources, by sharing the resources, by gathering them together when necessary, that require a that are required for a civilization to function. And so we need all of us is also conveyed in this image. The idea that the economy of humanity, the system of buying and selling, which is the giving of our love and our respect to each other, can't happen unless each and every one of the unique coins in God's mint, in God's treasure house, is not circulating in the way that it should. There is an additional passage that I wanted to share with you. This one comes from the 133rd Psalm, and it is a very famous line that has been put to music within the Jewish tradition. It says in the 133rd Psalm, Hine matov u'manayim shevet achim gam yachad, which translates to, behold how good and how pleasing it is for people to sit together in unity. I thought perhaps that I would share with you one rendition of this line from the Psalms as a way to further celebrate our theme for this evening. And that goes as follows, and you'll excuse my singing, in which I try to emphasize enthusiasm over musical talent. It goes, Hine matovu manayim shevet achim gam yachad. Hine matovu manayim shevet achim gam yachad. Hine matov shevet achim gam yachad. Hine matov shevet achim gam yachad. So there you go. I hope that all of us should be able to not only sit together in a good and pleasing way, but also work together and share together so that our human family can truly recognize the value of what comes about when all of us are needed and all of us work together to make the world a good and better place. Happy Thanksgiving.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبعد. Peace and blessings upon everyone from the one and only merciful God. I pray that this video or this live stream reaches you in the best of health, and I hope you and your family are doing well. There is a verse of the Quran. The verse is verse 13 of chapter 49. Ya ayyuha an-nas inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu inna akramakum 'indallahi atqakum. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلِيمٌ خَبِيرٌ. In this verse, God Almighty explains to us that every single human being is from Adam and Eve, and everyone has been created equally. إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى, that we have created you from one male and one female. وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلٍ, and the only reason that you have been created as different countries, as different nations, and as different people speaking different languages, looking differently, is because لِتَعَارَفُوا, so you may recognize one another. If everyone was the same, no one would recognize one another. But right after that, he says, which is the main point of the verse, Inna akramakum 'indallahi atqakum. Remember that just because you speak a certain language, just because you look a certain way or just because your complexion is a little bit different from someone else, it does not mean that you're better than them in any way. Rather, the best of people are those who are the most God-fearing. Inna akramakum indallahi atqakum. That we fear God and that we're conscious of God in all of our actions and in everything that we do. And from this verse, we realize that each and every single one of us is created equally. Now, if we look to the USA, the population of the USA, there's about 60% of white people. There's about 80% of Hispanic people. I'm just 18%. I'm just giving rough estimates over here. Muslim population is about 1%. And when we realize this, we realize that not one population or not one type of people can really accomplish anything by themselves. Everyone has to come together if and when they want to do something collectively, and that's the theme of today. We need all of us. It's not one group of people, not one type of people from one nation or from one country. Actually, all of us have to work towards a better world and a better country. We realize from these verses and all everything that has been said that God did not create us to hate. God did not create us to kill, to murder, to spread injustice. Rather, God created us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to love and to spread peace and to be tolerant of one another, even though we're different. God has created everyone differently, but that does not mean that we hate one another or we put up barriers and we put up walls because another person or another country is different than us. What we have been taught by our prophets, by our saints, is that we need to love one another. No legitimate religion teaches people to spread violence. And we need to understand that. Anytime you see violence on any side, whether it's the left, the right, the far left, the far right, or the people in the middle, anytime you see violence, remember those are not the people who are following the religion. Rather, they're following their own desires and they're there to spread hate and spread bigotry and spread racism. And we need to really understand that. Everything starts with ourselves, actually. As Dr. Martin Luther King once said, that darkness cannot drive out darkness. Only light can do that. So if there's darkness and there's hate and there's bigotry and there's racism, the only way to rectify the situation and the only way to improve the situation is to spread love and peace and harmony. That is the only way. We cannot fall into the trap of spreading that bigotry even further. And he goes on where Martin Luther King says, only love can do that. Only love can drive out darkness. And this is something that we all need to take back from today, that if there is darkness, the only way to drive it out is if we spread love and harmony and peace. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Thank you so much.
Sings along,
boom, 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 boom.
So lift your voice. Hello, I am Frank Katowski, minister for Summerland Church of Light. The Three Village Interfaith Clergy Association decided to give the offering for tonight's Thanksgiving service to the Island Harvest Food Bank. A slide presentation will show images from Island Harvest, along with information on where and how to send your generous donation. Island Harvest has provided me with information about their organization. Island Harvest Food Bank, the largest Long Island-based hunger relief organization, has been at the forefront of responding to the growing needs of Long Islanders who are food insecure and impacted by COVID-19 since our emergency response center was activated on March 9th, 2020. Amid an unprecedented surge in demand for food assistance across Long Island, our expertise in offering specialized food support and providing targeted services in crises helped to ensure that we could pivot our work and meet the new demands for assistance. Our innovative cross-sector programs target the root causes of food insecurity among working families, senior citizens, veterans, and children. Through strategic partnerships in communities and with hospitals and related organizations, we collaboratively address chronic food insecurity, physical and mental health conditions, and substance abuse disorders using unique program models. Island Harvest Food Bank pairs specially designed initiatives with nutrition education, outreach, mobile food distribution, and resource referral services designed to create pathways that address specific social determinants of health. Island Harvest Food Bank is a proud member of Feeding America, the nation's leading domestic hunger relief organization. All Island Harvest programs have been modified and adapted to ensure continuity of services for the most vulnerable members of the Long Island community. Through these increased efforts, Island Harvest Food Bank has been able to distribute more than 8.3 million meals to more than 400,000 individuals and families affected by the pandemic, over 10 million pounds of food. Please give generously. We bless the giver and the gift. Thank you.
Thank you all for your generosity in helping to feed the many people on our island who are food insecure. We need one another now, as always. Richard Visconti and Elaine Lernard and I, Margie Allen, would like to lead you now in a litany of affirmation of the unity that holds us all and moves through us all. We invite you to respond with these words: all of us need all of us to make it. All of us need all of us to make it.
These are useful words, a reminder that we are all connected and all deserving of the opportunity to thrive.
All of us need all of us to make it.
Other people's lives matter. Our families, our neighbors, our fellow citizens, strangers and friends who share with us the gifts of life on earth. Suffering anywhere concerns us all. Wherever we are on the web of life, which defines us all as kindred beings.
All of us need all of us to make it.
On a globe in which all of us are vulnerable to a formidable pandemic virus, we take every step we can to protect one another from infection. We will work together to say no to this killer of 250,000 of our fellow Americans.
All of us need all of us to make it.
In societies like ours, in which the contributions of essential workers are generally unseen, unappreciated, and undercompensated, and often involve considerable risk to the workers themselves and their families, we remind ourselves,
all of us need all of us to make it.
In a world in which some of us are targeted for poverty, struggle, and brutality, and others benefit from fewer barriers on the path to prosperity, we say,
all of us need all of us to make it.
In a nation and a world in which powerful people are able to direct the goods of life toward themselves, with little regard for the well-being, safety, and future of their kindred citizens, their nation, or our shared earth home, we say again,
all of us need all of us to make it.
In the excruciating spaces between obliviousness and acknowledging and naming, between refusing to listen and understanding and changing, we insist,
all of us need all of us to make it.
Picture in your mind, if you will, someone you know who is struggling to imagine an America in which all people in the natural world we share have an equal opportunity to thrive. Perhaps this is you, yourself, your spouse, maybe, people in your extended family, a coworker. Say to them with compassion for the struggle,
all of us need all of us to make it.
This Thanksgiving and in this season of holiday light, we resolve anew to see and acknowledge the worth and dignity of every person we encounter, to express our gratitude for their contributions to our common life, to widen our circles of relationships to include people who are not like us, and to do what we can to create an America in which love reaches everyone, because
all of us need all of us to make it.
All of us need all of us to make it.
All of us need all of us to make it.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We sing now together our song of thanksgiving, rejoice in the goods which the ages have wrought, for life and for
our forebears once sung. We sing of the freedoms which martyrs and heroes have won by their labor, their sorrow, their pain. The oppressed and befriending, our ampler hopes defending, their death becomes a triumph. We sing of the prophets, the teachers, the dreamers, designers, creators, and workers, and seers. Our own lives expanding, our gratitude commanding, their deeds have made immortal their days and their years. We sing of community now in the making, in every far continent, region, and land, with those of all races, all times and names and places, we pledge ourselves in covenant firmly to stand.
Let me first read a text from New Testament, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 15 and 16. Here it goes. Now, if the foot should say, because I am not a hand, I do not belong to the body, it would not for that reason stop being part of the body. And if the ear should say, because I am not an eye, I do not belong to the body, it would not for that reason stop being part of the body. And if one part suffers, every part suffers with it. This is about a body that needs all the membranes to maintain its wholeness. Have you ever tried to prioritize the level of importance of your body part? Normally, We are not interested in making the list. I believe it is because we know deep in our heart that every single membrane is integral to the wholeness of our body. We can say the same about our society. It also consists of all different membranes. They are the leaders and the ordinary people, the haves and the have-nots, the white and the colored, which is not my favorite ramification, the majorities and the minorities, the so-called mainline and the immigrants, the straight and the LGBTQ, etc., you name it. Just as with our body, I also believe we know deep in our heart that each membrane is integral to the wholeness of our society. Unfortunately, at times, people try to exclude and marginalize others who are different from them for various reasons. We need to reverse the trend. We need to see the divine image of God, which is embedded in every single individual, regardless of their color, social status, sexual orientation, or political and religious persuasion. We do not always see the value of their being part of our society and appreciate them enough. At times, we fail to see the whole picture in which we are closely interwoven and rely on each other. A while ago, I hurt my right thumb fingernail a little. I thought it was no big deal. I could carry things using the rest of my fingers. Then, the next morning, suddenly I found myself in trouble. I try to close the buttons on my shirt to go to the church. Being right-handed, though, I could not do that. It was an eye-opening experience to me. I hope we rediscover with God's help the value of the holding right arm in our society. I pray God enlarge our minds and hearts, our perspectives on each other and other groups of people in it. The truth should be like, we are not taking advantage of each other, but rely on each other. We are dependent on each other, not only for our personal interests, but also for the wholeness of our own humanity. And truly, we need all of us for that purpose. Amen.
Amen. I would just like to say this evening that I thank God that we are able as a community to come together to begin this holiday season. And we come together as a community, and I believe that Setauket and Stony Brook and the surrounding areas is and can be and is that beloved community that Dr. Martin Luther King spoke about. We have a great opportunity to come together over this vehicle of Zoom, and we have the opportunity to come together in our communities to give thanks for one another and give thanks to Almighty God also. So I say thank you this evening for Zooming in. Thank you for listening in to our gathering. And I want to say a special thank you to the Three Village clergy and all the work that they have done, that we have done over the year. So I say God bless you and God's peace be with you. And may you have a safe and happy holiday season. God bless you and God's peace. Amen.
Amen.